The World Cricket Carnival of 1992 progressed to the knockout stage now. It was a nail-biting tournament so far with lots of surprises. And most of the cases both teams go in toe-to-toe. Till the last day it was a question who will play in semis.
By 1 run, Australia, what a finish!
Both New Zealand and England secure their semi-final spots during the first half of the competition. And there was a battle between South Africa, West Indies, and Pakistan for the remaining two spots till March 15th. At that stage, New Zealand leading the table with 14 points in 7 games, England at number 2 with 13 points in 7 games, followed by both South Africa and West Indies 8 in 7 games, and Pakistan 6 from 6 matches. Team South Africa secured their place in that evening after beating India. However, competition might push to a different level if table turns to India's way. In that case, they too might have a shot for semis. But after the loss, they kicked out of the tournament, giving South Africa a secure spot among top 4 teams.
A magnificent effort chasing the 4 for 100.
On the last day, Pakistan beats unbeaten New Zealand and West Indies lost to Australia, which leaves Pakistan as the 4th contestant in the knockout round.
Wide of mid on, that's to the boundary, and that will give Pakistan the victory that they need to get through to 167 for 3 in the 4th.
No one thought New Zealand make it thus far. They were totally under radar, but they showcase a world-class performance to end the round-robin stage. This World Cup is a tournament to remember in New Zealand cricketing history. They beat all other teams, except Pakistan in group stage. Before the tournament begins, no one predict that type of world-class performance from this young and inexperienced team. Like other teams, they don't have much star players, except their skipper Martin Crowe. Even he joined the side after keeping aside his medical warnings. Due to his injury, he was warned thoroughly not to play. But his batting skills gave a much-needed moral and boost to New Zealand camp. He brought a revolution to New Zealand cricketing history with young and inexperienced team with this team spirit. He introduces the cricketing capabilities of players like Deepak Patel, Gavin Larson, Chris Harris, and Rod Latham to the world. They laid the foundation to the New Zealand's fame. With the combination of his leadership, batting, and strategies, no one able to pass Martin Crowe as a captain this tournament. During this tournament, Martin Crowe turns himself to a cricketing giant, and Mark Greatbatch became a pillar of New Zealand's success story. Crowe introduced some unorthodox strategies, and making Greatbatch as an opener is one of them. His pinch-hitting skills over fielder's head in initial 15 overs gave a good start for New Zealand batting lineup most of the time. Another Crowe's revolution decision was to bring the off-spinner Deepak Patel as the opening bowler. He was the most economical bowler thus far, and no other bowler has succeeded like him in initial 15 overs. Out of the 9 teams, England was the most balanced side, as they consist the greatest number of all-rounders. None of them second to the other. They said England will go down due to skipper Gooch's injury and seasoned campaigner Alan Lem's poor performances. But all these myths fall apart due to their teamwork. This is England's best ever shot in World Cups so far. They wanted to correct what happened in 1987. Some played superbly as individuals in few occasions. But almost all the cases, they have showcased their teamwork out of everything. They have a great advantage, which other 8 contestants don't have. The Team England contains the most number of all-rounders, starting from Captain Gooch, legendary Botham, Hick, Lewis, Pringle, De Freitas, Reeves, etc. They played their part as a batsman, safe fielder, as well as the bowler. All other teams consist a player or two like this type of caliber. However, players like Smith, Fairbrother, Hick, Botham, Stewart, and Lewis laid the foundation for England's success story this time. South Africa, who enters to cricketing world after 22 years showcase, they still carrying out the spirit of their cricketing ancestors' legacy. They showcase the era of Pollock brothers, Barlow, Proctor, and Richards can continue after generations. They start the tournament by defeating Australia in their first ever game, followed by defeating Zimbabwe, mighty West Indies, as well as Pakistan, and ended up their journey after qualified in semis. Before the tournament begins, world knows who Kepler Wessels is. Undoubtedly, he is a world-class level batsman. Due to English country championship name of Peter Kirsten and Alan Donald, names are somewhat familiar. When tournament progressing, world got to know some new names, names which are hidden to the outside world till now, but when it comes to cricket, their skills not second to anyone. Players like Andrew Hudson, Adrian Kuiper, Hansi Cronje, Jonty E. Rhodes, Brian McMillan, Richard Snell, and Merrick Pringle played their part when needed and laid foundations to these victories. Other pacemans are not as quick as Donald. but they had a good discipline to pitch the ball in right spot and right speed. When it come to batting, they execute a correct strategy. When require a short run, they took the chances, and when they need some boundaries, they never hesitated to go for big hits. When in field, they showcase a remarkable skills, and Jonty E. Rhodes was like a feather in a breeze. Within all of these pluses, there is a big shadow of a giant called Peter Kirsten. By scoring 5 half centuries in his 8 matches, Kirsten gave his 100% as a middle order or as an opener based on the situation. He was the strongest pillar of South African story. Pakistan was the unluckiest team so far. They lost their lethal fast bowling firepower, Walker Yunus, before the tournament begins due to an injury. His contribution badly hit Pakistan, especially a game against South Africa. It was 2 easy points to Pakistan, but rain washed away their hopes. Also, their key all-rounder Wasim Akram and solid batsman Salim Malik not up to the mark so far, which lead Pakistan into their back foot. However, Javed Mayended, Imran Khan, Ramiz Raja, Mushtaq Ahmed, Inzamam-ul-Haq and Amir Sohil dragged Pakistan out from their shameful fate. It seems Great West Indies heading to their downfall. Their key trump cards, legendary Malcolm Marshall, Skipper Richardson and Gus Logie, keeps failing. 2 inexperienced batsmen, Brian Lara and Keith Arthurton, took the lead role to bring West Indies into this level. Lara shows his caliber to replace the legendary opening batsman, Gordon Greenidge. Even he misses his long-standing opening partner, Desmond Haynes gives back his 100%. Once they were the fastest and the greatest. But this era, other countries slowly line up some pace man to overtake the mighty bowling attack. If Caribbean firepower triggers, story could have written in a different way. Hosting nation and the defending champion Australia was having a hard time in their own backyard. They were continuously succeeding after their title win in 1987, and before the tournament begins, they were one of the hot favorites. It was not surprise to keep high hopes on Kangaroos. They demonstrate some outstanding skills among all other teams in both Test and One Day Arena in the recent past, including the historical win of 4-1 against mighty West Indies in Carabin. On the other hand, this time they are playing in their own country in front of their own spectators. So, the stage has been set up for their favor. But they were beaten by underrated Kiwis in the opening game. And they lost to World Cup debutant South Africa in the next game. This 2 blows gave big impact to Australian story. Alan Border is passing his darkest hour as a captain as well as the batsman. This is the unluckiest period of his career. Vice-captain Jeff Marsh is the other unluckiest player. Due to his poor form, sometimes he was not selected for the playing 11. Waugh Brothers and Dean Jones tried to get Australia out from this situation. But they didn't get much support from their teammates. Except Dave Boone, he is the only Kangaroo batsman to maintain his form throughout the series. 1983 winner and the only Asian title champion Team India was not able to demonstrate their capability this time. They have a good set of players, but they were not able to execute their strategies as a team. Especially the performance of opening dasher Krish Srikant and Sanjay Manjarekar hit Indian side badly. Despite all the odds, a youngster Sachin Tendulkar showcased the world his ability. He was just 19 and playing his first ever World Cup. But Sachin demonstrate the skills not seconding to any world-class batsman and won many hearts and respect. Alone, Sachin played a major role in the handful of Indian victories this time. In addition to that, skipper Ajharuddin and legendary Kapil Dev play some responsible innings, especially the match against South Africa. Only associate nation Zimbabwe demonstrate a good progress compared to their 2 previous engagements. They build up a stage to elevation to full member status, firstly, beating Holland in ICC tournament in order to qualify, and secondly beating mighty England in the tournament. In between 1987 and current World Cup, they lost their A-grade players like Peter Rawson and Kevin Curran. But, still they have players like skipper Houghton, Pycroft, and Trayakos who played their 2 previous World Cup appearances. Their major challenge was to adapt to the pace and bounce in Australian condition. On the other hand, they have no experience in Australia and they don't have any bowler who rated among international standards. Their main target was to get over the sides like Sri Lanka and India. But they lost both the games. Yet they earned some marks to their side as well, especially the match against Sri Lanka. Skipper Dave Houghton once again proves his ability as a captain. And youngster Andy Flower indicating a rise of new Zimbabwe era, which is a good sign. Also, their all-rounder Brandis listed among top wicket takers with his 14 wickets. His performance helped to beat England's side. Record-breaking Sri Lankan match and the outplaying England will give them enough points to win full membership in ICC discussion tables. Despite having two wins for the first time, Team Sri Lanka not being able to gain much out of the World Cup. However, two wins against Zimbabwe and South Africa was a milestone in Sri Lankan cricketing journey. Batting support of both opening batsmen Roshan Mahanama and Athul Samaraiskara helped Sri Lanka to stay in the game. Especially Mahanama scored three consecutive half-centuries at the beginning. Sri Lankan's main blow was the vice-captain Asunka Gurusingha's form. He scored just 36 in his initial 7 matches and scored 37 in his last match against Pakistan. Gurusingha was a reliable player thus far and unfortunately, he missed his rhythm in the middle of the World Cup. Man who played a fighting knock in Pakistan before the tour, Sanath Jayasuriya, too fails with his bat. But in the field he did his duty in style. Skipper Aravinda was on and off with the bat. Also some questioned his ability as the captain as well. Sometimes he keeps using his part-time bowlers in the innings and to control the scoreboard. Some occasions their main fast bowler Champaka left behind without completing his spell. But Sri Lanka failed as a team, so alone Aravinda cannot take the responsibility. They fail to execute their strategies to control last 10 overs in many games. But Premadiya and Anurazeri tried to get the grip to their favor. If it's not Arjuna, both these wins will be an unachievable task for them. Before the tournament begins, some questioned his selection to the playing 11. But he was the man in form throughout the tour from Sri Lankan's point of view. So, it's time for the knockouts and the first semi-final scheduled to play between tabletop New Zealand and Pakistan at the Auckland. In the group stage, New Zealand were lost only to Pakistan and everyone thought Kiwis will not let it happen for the second time. This is New Zealand's third appearance in World Cup semi-finals and Pakistan's fourth. But both teams were not making to the finals before. New Zealand skipper Martin Crowe won the toss in front of 40,000 spectators and he decided to bat first. So, they scored 262 runs for 7 wickets in their 50 overs, which is a competitive score in a big game.
Beauty! He's hit that in the air, this will be out. Caught in the deep, he's got him!
Despite of his injuries, Crowe played a captain's knock and he scored 91 runs.
Thank you, Richie. Martin Crowe pulls the first ball away for him. It's in close, got to be close, yes, beautiful bowling!
Even though it took 20 balls to get off the mark, Ken Rutherford destroyed the Pakistan bowling attack after that. He builds a partnership of 107 runs for the fourth wicket with Crowe.
That's gone. That's in the stands rather quickly. Well hit. That also has gone into the stands. Bowled that slow ball a few times. He had one success where for singles. And this could well be out. Pulling that one, and the keeper Noan Cowan takes the catch. So can you? Dear me.
Oh, he's got him, that's out, stumped. And the ball. And that's got away square, and over the top too, that may be... Backs away from that one and gets into the gap as well. And there's a mix-up, there's a run-out, yes, Crowe's gone. Imran. And a little nudge down there to third man, that'll be four. That one screaming to the boundary. It's in the air and into the gap. That's four. Big appeal. Got him. LBW. Yes, he's angled it back in. And into the gap. And no third man. That'll be four. Imran. Smith gets a full toss. He smashed it away. It's four, is it?
Pakistan has to maintain over 5 runs per
almost
over,
a gale now,
and they lost so
the
early
ground
in the innings.
That's a fine shot, that'll be four. Times that nicely, that'll go all the way.
Interesting, those Ladbroke sides, England are favourites. They've been in the business a long time, that's out, he's taken the top edge as he's gone for the sweep shot there.
That's
very, very firmly struck through mid-arm.
Imran came next, but he has struggled to find runs and scored 44 in 93 deliveries.
Deepak Patel continues. Ramiz Ranjit launches him over the gap into the. And that's another six. Great shot from Ramiz Ranjit. That's six. That's gone all.
Case of rain.
Vance coming back for it. Could be a good catch. It is.
Passing into the wind.
Striker. He smashed that one. Beautifully hit down the ground. Way up into the terraces. What a magnificent strike. Good shot. Beautifully placed by Meander. That's four.
Through the covers. It was a controlled shot.
Man there. Under it. Caught. Imran's gone.
Just after Imran
left,
Malik followed him. Match turned out to Pakistan favor after these two dismissals. The way Crowe and Rutherford built key innings, youngster Inzamam-ul-Haq built a quick 87-runs partnership with informed batsman Myanmar.
Just 15 innings.
Haq showcased a remarkable courage and scored 60 off 37 balls with 7 fours and a 6.
Pakistan will believe that they can get these runs now.
Off, it would never have been in any doubt. That's a magnificent shot. Four. This is Morrison. That's four. Wide delivery off the bottom edge.
He won. Must be very worried at the moment.
Oh, he's hit that one in the air and into the gap. It won't get to the boundary, will it? Yes, it will. It runs in.
And probably not a very good decision.
There's no way he can give him out there. Oh, and that's
gone. Gone this time. Got... Denny Morrison coming in around the wicket to the left-hander. Full toss, he beats it, that go all the way, that's four. That's what Pakistan...
And giving the batsman room to hit.
Watson around the wicket. He's charged, he bowled him! Oh, available! Wicketkeeper coming out. Bad ball, and that's four. That's what they need.
Money to lay.
Big hit, it's gone for six, it's going all the way! That's six over off!
Talk about 10 runs back into the crowd. 6 runs
in their last 10 overs.
Pakistan's
Pakistan scored 77
lot
in their last 9. New Zealand trumped card Deepak Patel his initial 7 overs for 17 runs, but he got hammered 33 in his last 3 overs. So
that,
after a surprising comeback, Team Pakistan advanced to the final for the first time
enormous
in the World
pressures,
Cup history.
Has the nerve and courage to have a long off for 6. Small ground Eden Park, but it's not easy to do when you've got 40,000 fans here. And think of the millions around the world watching this telecast. He's pulled it. Man out there at square leg. He's defending. It's going fine. It could go all the way. He's coming around quickly. We die. That's 4 runs. And Pakistan have won the first semi-final at Eden Park. A magnificent performance by Javed Meander, Inzamam-ul-Haq. And...
Crowd gathered to Sydney Cricket Ground on March 22nd to witness the second semi-final battle between England and South Africa. This is first World Cup appearance for Team South Africa. But on the other hand, England has played in semi-finals for last 4 World Cup competitions, and this is their 5th time in World Cup knockouts. Group stage, England has beaten South Africa, but before this match begins, they had to rest their key players like Derek Pringle and Robin Smith due to bad health. Also, skipper Gooch, Lewis, and Lamb played with some injuries.
Good shot.
Coin toss turns into South Africa's favor.
That's what he's there for.
Despite the weather conditions, they decided to ball first. The match was restricted to 45 overs before it starts due to wet conditions, and England scored 252 for 6 in their 45 overs. England top scorer Hick was challenged for LBW in his first delivery, but it got turned down, and he gave a slip catch in his third ball, but it was called a no ball.
Same shot, same result.
Oh, that's a very good shot. He really hit that. Beautiful.
Got him. Brilliantly done. David.
That's beautifully hit. 45 minutes left now.
And for one of them, it's even less than that. Can't do much about that.
But not anymore. Oh, that's beautifully played.
You'd have thought John Major would have got a better seat than that.
It's a great shot. Lamb hitting the fence on the 4 over cover. It's gone, bottom edge. That's the break that South Africa needed, going for the square cut. It was wide enough to hit. But Donald.
Lewis and Reeve scored a cameo in last five overs, and they scored 50 runs. They scored 17 runs in Donald's last over.
It's gone again. That could be six. That's a big long hit.
In South African innings, they lost their skipper first and their in-form batsman Kirsten Cheapley.
That's the wicket of England wanted.
What a delivery. What a blow for England. The Freitas, who's been their best bowler, not just here tonight, but in other games.
Hudson and Kuiper maintained the run rate, but Illingworth finally sent both to dressing room.
A beautiful piece of bowling.
He's gone with him.
Next, Cronje and Rhodes took their turn, but after some time, Small took both the
straight
wickets.
Straight down to square leg. It's going to be out. It's well held. Not a problem at all. Graham Hick. Again, he's gone for this time. Lewis is underneath. He's going to catch it. Chris Lewis, very, very cool under pressure at deep point. He'd been moved out there two balls previously by Graham Gooch.
South African last hope McMillan and Richardson start build the innings, but rain ruined their effort. At one stage they required 22 runs in 15 balls, but then it reduced to 22 runs in one ball due to the rain rule.
They don't want to give South Africa any extra deliveries, and also the outfielders making throws, it'll be tough.
No one hits a strike. Fairbrother coming around. It's two more. Super over for South Africa.
And now the umpires are going to have a chat.
They've only got 45 overs, and they're coming off. The crowd will roar here at the Sydney Cricket Ground. It's certainly quite steady, a very difficult situation for the umpires. It's getting heavier by the second.
Scandalous that the rain-affected match rules now decree that South Africa need 22 runs off seven balls. Worse though to come, amid endless confusion, the composers of these absurd rules decide South Africa now need 22 runs from a single ball. Can one forgive those that invented these rules for spoiling a world event?
And the scoreboard finally confirming what we've thought to be true for some time now. South Africa need 22 runs off this one ball. Delighted, but a disappointing end to a wonderful semi-final. In comes Chris Lewis to bowl the final delivery. It's pushed away to mid-wicket. You can see that all the players are disappointed with that end. The crowd will roar here at the Sydney Cricket Ground. So at the end, it's England and a disappointing finish to a wonderful match. Disappointed Brian McMillan, captain of vessels, the manager Ray Jordan there.
So England team advanced to the final FR the third time.
And a very good defending performance also by England.
The stage has been set for the grand finale in Melbourne in between England and Pakistan. England has played in finals in 1979 and 1987, but this is Pakistan's first ever World Cup final appearance. Let's find out what has happened in our final episode next.